How's it going, guys? Toby introducing you to the Honeycomb Interspersed Venting and Exhaust Radio Pouch, or HIVE Radio Pouch. This was developed by user request for a modern radio pouch that could accept the PRC-163 MPU5 as well as other radios and accommodate all of the features that new, modern, and advancing radios come with that need to be addressed with a radio pouch, as at the end of the day, all of these things have to be carried on the body. Some of the wickets this new radio pouch would have to hit would be to accommodate larger radios like the 163 and others as they use their side connectors. Radios are only getting a bit larger as they try to cram more in there. And the other wicket was that it would have to be able to dissipate heat well since they're getting hotter as well as they get more advanced and stuff. I'm not an electrical engineer, so I don't know about that, but I do know about radio pouches, and so we designed one that can accept larger and hotter radios. It also had to accommodate the side connectors, as most of these do require a side connector to be used, especially the MPU5 for its push-to-talk, as well as other systems that it might be connected to. Same thing goes for the 163, and even the 152 and 148 have their own connectors that need to be addressed. A lot of radio pouches out there don't address them. Starting to go into design, the HIVE radio pouch can accommodate the 163, the 152, the 148, and the MPU5 radio, as well as some of the larger law enforcement and civilian radios like the Motorola XTS5000. The way it accomplishes this is through a number of designs where we have shock cord keeping these two panels together, and this is what allows it to expand width-wise, and then our bottom flap and our top strap allow it to be controlled height-wise as well. On the front, you'll notice the hexagons or the honeycomb interspersed venting. That is there for that airflow so that a lot of the radio surface area can basically have air pass over it and dissipate that heat. And that is one of the ways we accomplish that just heat dissipation. We also achieve that with some of the air gaps around it that allow it to basically just breathe a bit more and allow that heat to not get caught up inside of the nylon too much. The main body stretches to accommodate all of these radios as well as side pin connectors. And the way it does that is through the shock cord found on the sides, and that is what keeps the front assembly tied to the rear assembly. This is a continuous piece that also then transitions to the top strap as well and can be tightened down. But this is how we get all of these radios in there, at least width-wise, and their side pin connectors as well. The shock cord can be adjusted at the top and features a cord lock that can be moved. So if you don't want to run it on the front, as demonstrated here, it can be flipped to the back by simply just removing it and then reweaving it onto the back pretty easily. The bottom features a flap, and this is how we control part of the height. So if you want this to hang lower and have the top higher, you can do that. Or if you want to push it up a bit more, you can as well. And it features a G-hook that is locked in once this is actually mounted together, and also additional slots so that if you want to lower this G-hook down further outside of just these ones on the front, it can go all the way down onto the flap as well. This also helps as if you aren't running the radio currently, let's say you've turned it into the comm shed or something else like that, it can be cinched all the way down so the bottom flap goes to the top and the top strap goes all the way down, and this creates a flat pocket. So if you're running this somewhere else, it doesn't actually create this big loose pouch that's just hanging whenever you're not using it, let's say in a training environment. The shock cord can be used to tighten this down as well. If you don't like how it comes out default, you can just go ahead and pull that shock cord out, tighten the cord lock, retie this knot, cut and burn the rest off if you don't want it, and really just dial in the tightness all the way down the body. Down here is a one wrap strap that is optional and removable, and it is used to basically capture the battery a bit more. So let's say it's hanging down there and you want to make sure that that doesn't come out or anything else like that. It comes installed and you just wrap the battery around that, and this also helps secure the radio a bit more. This is also how we achieve the battery swap in this, by essentially just undoing that G-hook on the bottom, letting the radio slip out a little bit, undoing the one wrap, switching out your battery, and then wrapping that battery back up and reapplying the bottom strap. On the inside are these two inner flaps that you can see. They're kind of like wings. They're there to help cover the radio up and protect its sides if needed, or they can be folded down and out of the way. Let's say you're using side connectors or you want to maximize the air that passes over the radio, you can just fold them down and have the base of the radio pinch them in place against the base of it, and those will stay out of the way of side connectors, but we do recommend trying to use them as much as possible just to preserve the radio, keep it protected a little bit, and just have it there. But if you don't want it, you can fold it in and it'll stay out of the way. Moving on to mounting the pouch, it does feature MOLLE on the back in half inch increments, so that gives you a bit more freedom for mounting on various platforms, and it just takes up two columns of MOLLE on any plate carrier, chest rig, or the sort, and just weaves in and out. So if you know how to use MOLLE, you know how to mount this radio pouch as well. It can also help double for cable management, as if you have a lot of cables, you can have them stowed inside the pouch as well, depending on how you actually need to mitigate heat. If you have a cooler radio, this might be an option, but with a hotter radio, this might not be recommended. But either way, cable management is an option with it running back into the pouch as well, given that the pouch does stretch, and that might help with mounting your, you know, radio to anything else out there. Overall, the Hive fills an overlooked problem for a radio pouch that can adapt to the changing radio ecosystem that military and law enforcement face, and all the requirements that that entails. If you're issued any of these radios, check this out, as this may help you with operating your radio, stowing it, and just using it day to day. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below, DM us on Instagram, or email us at customerservice@shaw-concepts.com. If you'd like to check out any of our other offerings or just stay up to date with us, check us out at shawconcepts.com or on Instagram, Twitter, or Telegram. Thanks for your time, and go forth and conquer all.